last week we harvested our peppers. We had ghost peppers. We had the Fresno chilies. We had, what was those ones that you acted like you were going to eat?
Yeah, the Trinidad scorpions.
Trinidad scorpions. I'm not touching those though. And anyways, but what we did is we went and we harvested those peppers. This week I have dried the peppers. And I wanted to kind of go over what I do to get either pepper flakes or the pepper powder that we use in some of the meals and dishes that we cook here. So what I did is basically these are the ghost peppers. They started out, this was like heaped full when I started out.
Yeah, these are not dried yet. These are the
ones. These are not dried, yeah. I've got to dry these, and so I'm going to show you what I do to dry these. So let's go ahead and bring these over here real quick. And basically, this is my food dehydrator. It is by Presto, and I'll show you the, yeah, there you go. That's my dehydrator. And so basically, I just kind of lay these all out so that they're not like touching, so there's airflow in between all of them. And then I will let these dry, and I'll test them to see how they're doing. We've got a bunch of peppers out in the side yard as well that we need to do from our, what do you call it? Volunteer plans. Because we've got a bunch of them. Now, if they have bad spots, because I was just grabbing them, if they have bad spots, I'm not going to process those. I've got too many good ones that I am processing. So I'm not going to worry about the ones with the bad spots.
Do the green ones.
Huh?
Do the green, save me some of the red ones to.
Save you some green ones, or save you some red ones, got it.
For the seeds, yeah.
Okay. So I'm just going to hurry up and put these out real quick. With this one, it builds height by the way that you flip the lid. So if you need it a little bit higher, you can flip the lids around, which is pretty cool, I think. So these, I'm going to save. Some of them aren't good. Some of them Rob's saving for seeds. So I'm just going to put those over here so he can grab those here shortly. Next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and put my lid on my dehydrator. That's not going to sit on there real good. So to keep the lid off, I'm just going to pop another tray on here this way. There we go. And then all I have to do is plug it in down here. And it's off and running. All right, for the Fresno peppers, the way that I dehydrated those is that I didn't have enough room in my dehydrator. So what I did is I have got a convection on my oven. And so there's a difference in bake and convection bake. For some of you might not know, convection bake is where the heat or the oven has a fan in it, and when you put it on convection bake, the fan will blow and circulate that hot air. It causes things to cook quicker or to bake quicker, and so that's what I did. I put my oven on the lowest setting, which was 170 for my oven, and then what I did was take these are from Pampered Chef, but they're four. They've got these little legs that'll stand up for when you bring cookies and hot things out of the oven and you need to set them. They're cooling racks. And so what I did was I took the Fresno chilies and I just laid them like I did the food dehydrator. I just laid them on here so that they weren't quite touching. And with it being a wire mesh, that air still is able to blow through and circulate. And so that's what I did. And then this is what I ended up with for our Fresno chili peppers. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go ahead and process these. Now, Rob was talking about saving his peppers, all right? So this is basically whenever we get ready to harvest our seeds, this is kind of what he does. He's going to go and he's going to cut these open. He's going to get the seeds out of there. And he'll probably do a video on it or something. But this is kind of how we identify what peppers.
You can just show me. I'll just show you real quick. Doing it. We can trade camera. And you can. I'll just show you cutting. Yeah. Here. The swap is going on.
The swap is happening. All right. So we're going to see.
So what I do is get my handy dandy knife. And I just basically, here's all I do is I write down the name of whatever it is I'm saving, and I just cut it open in half and sometimes in fourths, but I just want it to dry out in there. And you can see I don't like to touch the wet stuff in there, because that's bad when you have an itch in your eye and you scratch it. So basically, to get those seeds to kind of dry, I just cut them open like that, and come back a little, you know, week later or whatever. I just have a stack over there, and I just stack all of my different seeds on top of each other. I have a big old stack of seeds, and they dry like that. So that's, oops, got a seed there. So I'll probably, peppers usually have about 50 seeds per pepper. I mean, I'm sure they're different for different varieties. In fact, I think ghost peppers have like 20. I could be wrong about that. And it varies from pepper to pepper. But anyhow, that's all I do. Just cut them open, let them dry, and then I come back and pull them apart and flick them out. They fall out of there really easy once they're dry. So that's all there is to it.
Very sweet.
Yeah.
All right.
They're not sweet. These are hot.
Spicy. All right.
Okay. So for the rest of the process, what I've got here, I have got a KitchenAid 9-cup food chopper or food processor. This one just came out not too long ago, but I love it. It's nice. It's handy. All of my different discs and accessories store in here, so I don't have them running around my countertops and everything when I'm not using them. And then the other thing for smaller batches, because you might not have a larger batch like I do here, but for the smaller batch, I have got the 5-cup food chopper. And that is a handy dandy little thing for making just like a small batch of salsa or maybe a little bit of hummus or something like that, salad dressing. So those are some really neat things to use for your little food chopper. But right now I've got all of these that I'm getting ready to do. I'm going to cut the end off where the stem was and before I put them in the food processor. So that's what I'm getting ready to do now. I've got a couple done here, so let me just throw those in and I'll just kind of go to town on these.
Now you could save those seeds from this if you didn't put them in heat.
But I use the heat method to dry them.
These are questionable. They may be okay, they may not be.
But when we do the peppers, that little stem part, that woody part around where the stem goes, I don't like those in my pepper flakes or my pepper powder. So, but I don't know about you, but my sinuses are starting to tingle. Let me get some of these off of here.
Touching it?
Mm-hmm.
You don't have an itch in your eye later on.
Okay. All right, so I think I'm about full enough right now. Now, I could do it either one of two ways. What I can do is I can either hit the low and just kind of watch it. I can hit the high and just watch it go real quick and definitely get it to that powder stage. But what I want to do is go to the pulse so I can control it. We are at the pepper flake.
Might as well just go ahead and add the rest of them on.
Yep.
Instead of,
I'm going to leave that lid shut for right now because I'm sure those oils have gotten stirred up a little bit. sometimes when you're doing it, it looks okay, but then when you take the top off, that's a nope. We're all like rearing back like hazmat suit.
You don't want to make it finer than that?
Do you want flakes or do you want powder?
I want powder.
Okay.
It's like maybe you could have used a smaller jar.
I know, that's what I was just thinking. Let's pour it in. Whoop, pour it in here. That works. Where'd my lid go?
Over here.
Oh.
Did you label it? You're gonna label the, oh, look at you.
We've got a label maker. And for my items that are up in here, you'll see I've got items labeled. So it just makes it nice and easy to see exactly what's in your jar. All right, so now I've got it all labeled. It's ready to go up on my shelf to join the other red pepper flakes that I've got up there. And then we went for the final step. We ground it up a little bit more and we put it in our bottles. And it is all set to go back up in the cabinet. So we've got our jars and then we've got our shaker bottles. And that's how we process our peppers. So we hope that you guys have a wonderful weekend. Thank you for hanging out with us here on our suburban homestead. And we'll catch you on the south side. God bless.